Yeah, so it's reasoning and aptitude for competitive exam.
Now you got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So now once again the second session of reasoning and aptitude for competitive examination. So here we have got, you have got a 9-digit number where two of the digits are represented by X and Y. X and Y are digits, like 3, 4, 5, they are digits actually. Two of the digits are blank, they are represented by X and Y. Where X and Y stand for the smallest possible digit between 0 and 9 such that this number is divisible by 72. So find the value of X minus Y. Actually you have to find the value of X and the value of Y, then afterwards you can find X minus Y. So a number is given where two of the digits are represented by X and Y. They are digits. They cannot be 23. They should be a 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. Single digit. X is a digit and Y is a digit and the number is divisible by 72. So what's the value of X minus Y? Got it, Vidhi?
Yes, sir.
So what is divisible by 72 is also divisible by 8 and 9 separately. 72, the factors are 8 and 9. What are the factors of 72? 8 and 9. So 8 and 9 being the factors, if it is divisible by 72, it should also be divisible by 8 and 9. So we check the divisibility by 8 separately and divisibility by 9 separately. You could have done anything first. Here we have done 8 first. You can also do 9 first and then 8. So for checking the divisibility by 8, we take only the last 3 digits. So we have taken the last 3 digits and try to divide. Ultimately we are getting 6y. So if you have to divide by 8, the only number is 64. 8 into 8 is 64. That means y should be 4. That is the only one. Otherwise there is no other number. 8 into 7 is 56. It will start with 5. 8 into 9 is 72. It will start with 7. So starting with 6, only one number is there, 64. 8 into 8 is 64. So y must be 4. Got it, Vidhi?
Yes, sir.
Now we check divisibility by 9. For 9, what we do? We add the digits. So when you add the digits, you are getting 46 plus x plus y. 46 you can add and then you have got x and y. Now, 46 means 9 into 5 is 45. So it is more than that, 46. And the next one is 9 into 6, 54. The next multiple, 9 into 5 is 45. So after 46, if you want a higher number, which is a multiple of 9, it is 54. So this has to be 54. That is the only smallest possible value for X and Y. So when you make it 54, then X plus Y is 8. This should be 8. Then only the total becomes 54. That is the nearest number, which is divisible by 9, so x plus y equal to 8. And y equal to 4, you have already seen here y equal to 4. So x plus y equal to 8 means x is also 4, y is also 4. That means x minus 5 is 0. Got it, Vidhi?
Yes, sir.
You can also check the first 9 and then 8. That also you can do. Now, the total number of students in sections A and B is 150. Total 150 students in section A plus section B. The average marks for section A is 86. The average marks for section B is 71. And the total average for section A and B combined for all the 150 students is 80. So this is the average for section A, this is the average for section B, and this is the combined average for section A and B together. So find the number of students in section A. So what we are doing here, mixing. You are mixing from section A, where the average is 86, some students you are taking, and you are mixing with section B, some students, where the average is 71. Two varieties of students. Just like you mix two varieties of sugar. One variety of sugar at 40 rupees and one variety of sugar at 35 rupees. Just the way you mix sugar, similarly you are mixing students, two varieties of students, one variety of students average 86, one variety of students average 71, and after mixing you are getting the net average 80. So there is the same thing as mixing sugar or mixing rice. You are mixing students where the values are 86 and 71, and after mixing the net value is 80. So whenever you have that kind of mixture problem, we will apply the cross difference method. What is the cross difference method? The higher value 86, the higher value 86, the lower value 71, and the mean or middle value 80. Okay, ready?
Yes, sir.
Now, cross difference. How do you do the cross difference? From here, cross difference, crosswise. 86 and 80, difference 6. Crosswise, 81 and 80 and 71, difference 9. So, 9 is to 6 is the ratio. But 9 and 6, kitna milta hai? 15. And I want 150 students. So, make it 90 and 60. Then it will give 150. So, 90 and 60, that means 90 in section A and 60 in section B. So, section A has 90 students. Okay, Betty?
Yes, sir.
A 60-liter mixture contains 10% water. How much water must be added to make 20% water? The mixture is already having 10% water, and you are going on adding water until the mixture contains 20% water. Now, we have solved it in three ways only to show that cross difference is the easiest and simplest method. But there are other methods to solve, but cross difference is the easiest method. When you are adding water, it is 100% water, pure water, only water, 100% water. And the mixture which you are taking, M is not milk, M is mixture. That is 10% water. So 100% water and 10% water, you are mixing, and the final result is 20% water. So we have a cross difference method. 100 subtract 20 to get 80. 10 subtract from 20 to get 10. So the ratio is 10 is to 80 or 1 is to 8. Now, the total volume given is 60 liter. So, 1 is to 8 means 1 by 8. 1 by 8 of 60 liter is 7.5 liter. Okay, Betty?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is the second method. In case in the exam hall, this you can't get them. Now, milk is constant. You are adding water, you are not adding milk. So, the quantity of milk before adding and the quantity of milk after adding water should be same. So initially it was 60 liter, then you added some water and it became 60 plus x liter. Originally the total quantity was 60 liter, then you added some water. Now the total volume is 60 plus x liter. The milk was 90%, 10% water means 90% milk. And now the milk is 80%, 20% water means 80% milk. But milk remains same, milk you have not changed. So this should be equal to this. So 90% of 60 liter is equal to 80% of 60 plus x liter. So you solve it, you get x equal to 7.5 liter. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, still third method. Initial mixture is 10% of 60 liter, that is 6 liter. 60 liter, 10%, 6 liter. Now, if 60 liter has 6 liter water, then the remaining milk should be 54 liter. 10% is water, sorry, not milk. 10% is water, so 6 liter water, and the remaining 54 liter should be milk. Now, 54 milk remains milk, it remains 54. 6 water becomes 6 plus x because you are adding water. And after adding, the 54 milk, that is 80%, and 6 plus x, which is water, is 20% or 4 by 1. Now 54 by 6 plus x equal to 4 by 1. So you cross multiply and you get x equal to 7.5. Okay, ready?
Yes, sir.
So you have got various methods of solving, but only the cross difference is the simplest method if you can apply it at the right time.
So
now HE whole power H gives you SHE. Now he and she are not people, they are not persons like masculine and feminine gender, not man and women. Here HE SHE are digits. S stands for a digit like 5, 6. E stands for a digit 2, 3, 4, like digits. So HE power H gives you SHE. Find S plus H plus E, where each letter represents a digit 0 to 9. Question clear, Babidi?
So, Babidi? Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, HE is a two-digit number. Which is the smallest two-digit number? It is 10. Two-digit number means 10 to 99, right? Starting from 10 to 99, so the smallest is 10. Let us take the smallest one. So, you are getting a three-digit number. So, the power can only be 2. If the power is 3 or power is 4, you will get a 4 or 5-digit number. 10 power 3 is giving you 1,000, 4 digits. 10 power 4 will give you 4 digits. So, 2 is the only power that will give you a 3-digit number. So, you conclude that H must be 2 because only you have to raise to the power 2. If you raise to the power 3, it will not be a 3-digit number. It will be a 4-digit number. So, if you raise to the power 4, it will be a 5 or 6-digit number. So, only the power possible is 2. Up to this clear?
Yes, sir.
So, the power H must be 2 because power 3 or power 4 or power 5 will make it a 4-digit number or 5-digit number or 6-digit number. So, you replace H by 2. So, you're getting 2e power 2. 2e power 2. 2e power 2 is giving you SHE. 2e power 2 is giving you SHE. That means these two digits are repeated here. 2e, when you are squaring it, the square of this number is giving you SHE or S2e. H is 2, so again you are getting S2e. So that means these two numbers are repeated, and the only such number is 25. The square giving you 625, where 25 is repeated, the last two digits. These numbers are called automorphic number. These are called automorphic number. The square of the number contains the same digits as the last one or two digits. So 2, 5, again the same digits are repeated. So 1 is 2, you know. So 21 to 29, 25 is the only number which is an automorphic, so that you get 625. So now you know S equal to 6. H equal to 2, E equal to 5, so S plus H plus E gives you 30. Got it?
Yes, sir.
A vessel is filled with syrup water mixture in the ratio of 5 is to 3. How much of the mixture must be drawn off and replaced with water to get a mixture half syrup and half water? Now, what is the meaning of 5 is to 3? Total is 8, so first will be 5 by 8, second will be 3 by 8. So syrup is 5 by 8 and water is 3 by 8. And the final mixture is half syrup and half water, so 1 by 2 syrup, 1 by 2 water. So 5 by 8 syrup decreases to 1 by 2 syrup. Whenever it happens like this, you can apply the compound interest formula. Only the thing is, instead of plus, you put minus. And don't use 100 because 100 is for percentage. Here you are, we are not getting percentage, we are getting direct fractions. So we get the initial value should be taken as the principal. The final value should be taken as the amount. So P, principal, 5 by 8, starting amount into 1 minus R. I am not writing R by 100 because it is not a percentage, it is a fraction. Is equal to final value amount 1 by 2. Now we can calculate R equal to 1 by 5. So 1/5 of the mixture must be replaced with water. Got it?
Yes, sir.
This can also be done by cross difference method because you are mixing two things. Now, in the first one, you have 3/8 water. And what you are adding? Pure water. You are replacing with water. That means 100% water. One water or 8/8 water. We have put 8/8 so that the denominator is matching. Otherwise, you can put one also. But for convenience, we have put 8/8. 3/8, 8/8, the denominator should be same. So 3/8 water in mixture and 8/8 or 1 or 100% pure water. And finally, you are getting 1/2 water or 1/2, we are writing as 4/8. So that all the denominator is same. So 3/8, 4/8, cross difference 1/8. 8/8, 4/8, cross difference 4/8. So ratio is 4:1. 4/8 is to 1/8, 4:1. So 4:1 means 4/5 is mixture and 1/5 is water. So this 1/5 of the water has to be added by replacing the by taking out the mixture, replacing with water. When you take 1/5 of the mixture, 4/5 of the mixture will remain, and in that place you will add 1/5 water. So 1/5 of the mixture is taken out and replaced with water. Okay, ready?
Yes, sir.
Any questions? Any confusion?
No.
Okay.